Thank you, Kiran. Honorable Minister Thiru Dayanidhi Maran, my colleagues on the dais and dear friends, it's my proud privilege to welcome you to the NASSCOM 2007 India Leadership Forum. This is an event many of us have come to look forward to, for being in the company of friends, collaborators, partners, competitors, investors, government representatives, media, and customers. Friends, the size of Indian IT and BPO industry has grown phenomenally over the years. And with it, the operations of NASSCOM and India Leadership Forum have witnessed similar growth. We had to be very selective this year as regards the quality of participants and the number of participants because of limitations of space. The number of delegates from overseas, CXO level participation, and quality of speakers has been significantly higher this year. Over the years, as you are aware, we have made it a practice to do a periodical assessment of the state of the industry through NASSCOM McKinsey study. I am pleased to report, as Kiran has earlier stated, that we are on course for a $60 to $75 billion exports and an industry size of $80 to $100 billion by 2010. IT and BPO service exports currently represent a significant proportion of India's overall exports. This industry now contributes more than 5.5% of Indian GDP, directly employs more than 1.63 million people, provides indirect employment to more than 2.5 times more people. Equally importantly, benefits from tens of millions of people through social responsibility initiatives of companies in the industry. Of the top 10 global systems integrators ranked market capitalization, half of them are from India. Per employee revenues among these Indian companies has been significantly lower. However, per employee market capitalization for many of the Indian companies has been upwards of $200,000 to $300,000, reflecting enormous investor confidence on their growth prospects. Liberalization and globalization on one hand, and the birth of offshoring model on the other, have changed the economic landscape of India in 1991. IT and BPO industry has grown by more than 300 times in the last 16 years. In the process, India has come to engage with the rest of the world quite intimately. For example, India enjoys as many relationships with the Fortune 500 companies in the services sector as China in the manufacturing sector. It is also gratifying to note that the manufacturing and services industries are reinforcing each other very effectively. Consequently, Indian economy has grown consistently at over 8%. Tata Steel's acquisition of Corus, a global steel company for about $12 billion, reminds us of the importance of globalization and a balanced growth. Emergence of India as the services hub of the world has come about in definitive and incremental steps. It first began with staff augmentation, acquisition of technology competencies, process orientation, and quality certifications, expanding global footprint. Investments in domain competencies have come in quick succession. Indian companies have now more or less come out of catch-up game with multinational counterparts. Issues that these companies are now facing are around leadership and innovation. Indian companies have come a long way from writing given lines of code efficiently to adding significant business value to their global customers. Servicing 65% of offshore global IT demand and 45% of BPO demand gives rise to a wide range of opportunities for global customers, investors, and service providers. And yet, the current service exports are catering to only 10% of the $300 billion addressable market. Here are some of the trends that we notice. Proportion of work in Europe and Asia Pacific regions has been increasing as compared to North America in the last 5 years. Vertical markets such as retail, healthcare, energy and utilities, travel and transportation have picked up momentum. Horizontal practices such as engineering services and infrastructure services seem to hold a lot of promise. A study by Booz Allen Hamilton and NASSCOM has identified the potential for India in emerging engineering services to be in the order of $40 billion by 2020. Global systems integrators have been aggressive in embracing the global delivery model for accessing talent and improving efficiencies. Established Indian companies have been augmenting the breadth and depth of their offerings by systematically filling the white spaces through acquisitions. These acquisitions have given them access to consulting capabilities, domain competencies, newer technologies, special geographies, and sizable customers. BPO is being seen as a natural extension of IT services. More value-added services such as KPO and more creative activities such as animation and gaming form part of these services.